Hello everyone, Xenon Zim here, and welcome back to Blastmaster Zero. Last time we got this place. Ugh. As you can probably tell, I don't like the sewers. I don't think anyone does, so I'm not in the minority. This time. I believe we should go this way. Okay, let's go inside. There are enemies which are going to be the bane of our existence. Just being real, they are the hardest enemies to deal with. Because of them being tough. Oh right, this is a restock room. And more because they're just annoying. In the original, you could get to the platforms in the middle of nowhere. Why would you? I don't know. In this one you can. So, don't try it. But I think we're on the right path. Back in water. Crumbling rocks. I will not lie, I don't know exactly where I'm meant to go. Always go left, because that's usually where things aren't. Now if we get up here, maybe we'll find something. Oh, it's this. The room that is kinda ruined for me, thanks to Proton John's LP of this game. I don't know if you can hear it, but it's rumble. It's strong. don't have the map, which is the big problem. If we had the map, we could easily get through this. Hatch, they'll spawn really annoying enemies, which become more annoying in the later games. Oh, we're at a boss. This is not the map room. What do we get? Oh no, we're Tadrolls. Yeah, these things. Let's guide them all around. Let's gather them up. Spam. Don't ever take a risk. Maximum shot. The beam weapon we're probably never going to use. But we do need it. Okay, we'll go this way. Oh no, this gimmick. This isn't as bad for this one, but there's a later one that is mean, especially in the original. And I believe it's another wave room. Yep, it is. Now let's run, and we'll have to wait, because I don't believe we can. No, we can do this. And wait. Grenade. I believe we can just go through here. Shortcut, so we have to go. Because I believe... Well, it shouldn't say shortcut. Just less dangerous. That's why I don't have to deal with this room that much. have to go for this. No, we're not gonna make it. Turn. Okay, that's the restock room. Let's flow. Let the rain flow. The good news is, there's a restock room. And we just went past it, so we can go restock. Now let's go. I wish this would go faster. But we have to take it slow. But now we've got the map. This dungeon won't be too bad. You know what? Now let us go away from this pain. Now let's drop in some water. Okay, now before we go on, we have a lot to do. The path to go is on top. We want to go to the bottom. I believe we have to go. Yeah, we have to destroy this before we can do anything. Great. Okay, now we can get to that area. Fully energized. This gets tied. Slash. Walking around the path of destruction, we shall totally be victorious. Let's go. Restock room. That is until we grenade. We get our first life up of this area. I believe there's only Maybe we're thinking of a different area, but this has two. Oh no, Def Am. Now we can go back out and get to the last two areas. Can't get here. Soon we will. Unless it's right here, in which case, yeah, no, it's right here. The fog was a bit later in the level. Now we can get into here, and let's go. Please, no more dark room. Good. Oh, we've got more wave room. Nope, there is. Actually, we can just check the room's layout. Yeah, no, we can just cheese our way free. And we made it. Flamethrower blocks. This joke of a flamethrower. Nope. Let's go. Dun, dun. Break it. And we've only got one more room to traverse. There we go. Checkpoint. Now let's go. This guy. Spork Salamander. And he's a joke. He actually takes quite a bit of damage from wave. So this guy really, really was weak to him. believe he's also weak to clay, so it's also that. I'm trying to get Spark Tackle! Spark Tackle! Now we can talk about that. Yeah, it's just that. Well, it's nothing too impressive. For a while, this is our best way of moving. So, that's been stuck on for a while. Okay. We took quite a bit of damage. Intention. We're using open missiles. Dodge. And checkpoint. Finally, we meet a frog. Got a huge meme here. Maybe it's my imagination, but I can't help think that it kind of looks like Fred. In the original game, this was, first of all, a top-down fight, and second of all, it was Fred. This has obviously changed. Ew, this thing is nasty, it's so slimy. Eve, I totally get what you're saying. Let's focus here. Right, here we go. The Earth-Shattering Tyrant. Ribberole. Ribberole is a joke. Oh. I don't fear this guy. And we got, instead of a power, key 1. Looks like a security key that opens shutters in the Warworks area. Right on. Looks like we'll be able to remove security and pry some more shutters open. Yep, I'll install the security program into your master rifle. You don't even have to exit the speed, just get close to shutters and you'll be able to create security. However, if you can't get close so long, you'll have to access on foot to get them open. Got it. Thank you. After all this, how are things going over in the glacier area? Hang on, just look a sec. Looks like there's even more of them now than there was before. Besides, Fred's signal still hasn't moved, but those mutants are gathering. There's a chance they might be after something. Let's get over there as quickly as we can. And our objective is up there. And you know what that means? More climbing. Team of this area is palpable. We can keep going up, but if we keep going towards the right. That. dodge. Full heal. I will dodge. Slow burn, but we can access this way. Get a shortcut back. Still doesn't change how long this area is, how dizzying it is. Ugh. This slowness is part of the reason why no one likes the goddamn sewer. Finally. Now we can get out. Oh. Now deal with more mutants until we get to the end. Heal as much as we can. And this. Take a running start and jump. In the original game, there was less. You had very little and there was no water. And would you believe me if I said there was an even worse one? Because there is. Don't jump, because you will get yourself killed. Normally, we can't just jump down there either. Now, with that, we're entering Area 5. The water city. Looks like from here on there's some man-made sea. This is gonna suck. Sabi doesn't have much underwater mobility. Skink Fubus is looking pretty impossible. If you can check to see if there's anything in the area that could help with Sophia's underwater mobility problem? Yep, already on it. Just give me a sec here. Got it. Looks like I'm getting a signal from the chip that looks like it can help getting Sophia from the sea. It's in the sea though. Guess I'll have to dive in there and go and fetch out myself. Or it's gonna be really rough, so please be careful. And we don't get to see where it is. Granted, at this time, it's the only option. So, next time, on Blaster Master Zero. We'll be dealing with the man-made sea and suffering. More. See you guys then. Xenonizuma, signing out.